long run average cost curve part 3. My previous lesson ends like this. 3. At the very outset, I wish you to understand a few things. One of the long-run objectives of the firm is to produce an output at the minimum possible average cost. Each point on the long-run average cost curve is tangent to a plant curve. Hence, long-run average cost curve represents not a few plant curves. In fact, it represents as many plant curves as there are points on the curve. Plant curve, I mean the short-run average cost curve of a certain size of a plant. Plant is the physical structure of a firm. So, a point on the long-run average cost curve shows the plant size, output, and the average cost. Please keep all these things in your mind when we try to find an answer for the given question. In our analysis, I will show only those plant curves that are required for our analysis for easy and better understanding. Take point A on the curve. It shows a specific plant size. At this point, the plant's short-run average cost curve, SAC1, is tangent to the long-run average cost curve. Again, it shows M units are produced at an average cost of MA. MA is the minimum possible average cost of producing M units. Now, the firm wants to expand the output. There are two options for the firm. First option is moving down along the SAC1 and reach its minimum point B. It means moving away from the long-run average cost curve. You must know, A is not the minimum point of SAC1. It is on the falling side of SAC1. Only such points can be tangential to the long-run average cost curve when it slopes downward. Minimum point B of the SAC1 can never be tangent to long-run average cost curve. The firm produces N units. Output N is larger than M. Average cost also falls to NB. We shall explore the second option. The firm can slide down the long-run average cost curve and reach the point D. It also represents output N. We know each point on the long-run average cost curve represents a plant with its own short-run average cost curve. So, at point D, there is a plant with short-run average cost curve SAC2. Look, SAC2 is tangent to long-run average cost curve at point D. If the firm uses this plant, it can produce the same output N units with a cost of ND. Average cost ND is less than average cost NB. You know pretty well, a firm would like to produce a given level of output at a least possible average cost. Hence, it is highly beneficial for the firm to move along the long-run average cost curve rather than moving down along the plant curve ACAC1. If the firm takes the path A to B and then to D, the long-run average cost curve would have scallop. But it doesn't do that. It takes the path of A to D. It slides down along the long-run average cost curve. Moreover, there are a number of plant curves in between A and D. The firm has to consider all these alternatives. That is the reason why the firm slides down along the long-run average cost curve. What is true of this segment is true with all over the curve. Hence, the long-run average cost curve takes a smooth, flat-bottomed U-shape. Thanks for watching. We shall meet again.